All right, guys, this video is going to be straight to the point. You're probably using the sample stem extraction completely wrong. Let me show you why. So here's a part that we want to take from the song. We just want the drums. Now, what most people will do, they'll make the sample unique, for example, and then they'll just extract the stems from here. Now, let's do this step by step to show you guys why the way you're doing it is probably wrong. Let's extract the stems. We want all of the stems in this case. Now, the reason we're doing this is because we're using a small chop. And basically what most people do is, let's say they want the drums, they'll just delete the bass, the instruments, and the vocal and think that that's the best quality drum. But let me prove it to you guys that it's not the best quality. So firstly, we need to wait for the system to do it. It takes a long time to extract. So that's why I don't recommend this. It just takes way too long. This was a very small clip. Let's drag it to the beginning of the project. And let's compare our way of doing this versus the AI. So firstly, what we want to do is take out the drums. So let's copy this. Now, what most people do, again, they make the mistake. They'll simply just mute out what they don't want. So they'll mute the vocals, the bass, and whatever. Let's turn this down. It's a little loud. So to be fair, we have to make sure everything turns out the same way. If you listen, it sounds very plasticky. It sounds like there's like a woof sound to it, like somebody's like doing this to the vocal, to the audio. It's like a film over the audio. Here's the original just for context. Very full, okay? And then here's... it's like a filter plus like a transient gate. So we're losing a lot of information. So let me show you guys a more modern way. What we want to do here is keep the original. So let's see that let's lower this the same amount. So let's do -6.7. So they have the same level. Then what we're gonna do is find the vocal track. So let's do this, vocals. We're gonna unmute it. And then what we need to do is double click in the vocal track and flip the polarity, because what we're doing is canceling out the original vocal. We need the same exact volume, same timing, same pitch and everything. So in this case, I need to reset that volume. What I'll do to compensate is send this stuff to the mixer so we're not blowing out my speakers. And then we will route it to this track here and just turn the volume down. All right, that way. Look, this is like clipping, okay? All right, so here's our version. Okay, the drums are very full. All we did was we took out the vocals. Let's say you don't even want the bass. Let's remove the bass. Double click in here, flip the polarity of the bass. Okay, so let's go back. Actually, I kind of like it with the bass. So let's say we want the bass in the track, and then we'll do drums and bass. So let's compare the AI version. I'll restore the volumes and everything with our version to the right. It sounds like a filter. It sounds very plasticky. Now here's our version with the vocals. Ours is way more full. You can feel those drums. There's nothing. Just listen to how compressed these sound. So again, to the beginner who might not understand the difference, on the left side, when we're extracting the AI stem stuff, the reason it's not high quality is because the algorithm is using like this general logic to take out stuff. So when it wants to extract drums, it uses a general logic. When it wants to extract bass, it uses this general logic. But the problem is it runs everything through the same logic and it takes out a lot of stuff and information. And that's why it sounds kind of weird. But when we do the flip polarity of the vocal, what we're doing is purposely leaving the original in, and all we want to remove is the vocal. So what we do is we duplicate the vocal and we flip the polarity, meaning for every plus one, we're introducing a minus one. So plus one minus one is even, it's zero. And so we're flattening out the vocal by canceling itself out by flipping the polarity. And so instead of running it through all these filters, we're just saying, here's the original minus the vocals. and you get a lot more detail that way. And we could do it the opposite way, just to show people like this, not just about vocals, but I found that vocals is the easiest because vocals are easier to deal with. So let's do the same exact thing, but with the bass. Let's say we want to take out just the bass. Let's do drums, actually. Let's double click. Now, again, vocals are a little bit easier because it's not as much like harmonic activity and noise. But let's flip the drum polarity, and we should just have the vocals from the original record. Now, we do have some artifact, again, because there's a lot of components there. We also have the bass still. So if I wanted to target the vocal specifically, I would go to all the other elements outside of the vocal, double click, flip the polarity. And then that don't, let's reverse that too. So I'm going to the extreme here. Let's flip this. So now all we should hear is the vocal. Now let's So there's, it sounds similar tonally, but when you listen to it, it sounds thin and compressed. Sounds very similar. So in that case, the vocal didn't really sell me on this, like going through all this process. But basically what will sell you is when you invert the vocals and you leave everything else. Then you really hear the difference between the AI filters and your track. So usually I only do this when I need to remove a vocal from something, and I want to keep all the original detail, but just remove the vocal. So that is what I wanted to show you guys. Let me figure out how to do all this. So let's compare. So again, we're removing the vocal. So this is the AI running through a bunch of filters. Sounds very thin and compressed. Here's our version by just simply inverting the vocal. Like you could feel the drums, whereas over here. There's no feeling to it. All right, so let me know if you guys hear a difference in the comments. Again, I don't want to make this video super long, but if you guys want to understand AI stuff, go to busyworksbeats.com/AI. I'm pretty sure I have the hyperlink ready. If not, I'll make the hyperlink ready. I have a course on how to use AI for music, but I only use AI for like making samples and stuff like this. But when it comes to mixing and everything, you guys need to understand sound design, mixing, music production. Go to busyworksbeats.com/premium. Subscribe if you're new. It's busyworksbeats.com. Peace.